Morning, fifth class children. Today we are going to start volume 2, children. Let us learn course book lesson, The Wind and the Leaves. It's a poem. The poem describes the relation between the wind and the leaves. Let us learn that, children. Turn page 4-5 from your course book, The Wind and the Leaves. Take your pencils also so that you can write meanings. Look at the book. Page number 4. The Wind and the Leaves. The Wind and the Leaves. By George Cooper. Who is the author of this poem? George Cooper. Let us see. Let me show you the picture first. Look at the picture. Look at the tree, beautiful leaves, colors, yellow, red, green. The combination is very, very nice, no? What is happening with the leaves? What is the season? It is mentioned here. Can you identify the season? When do leaves turn red, children? And when do they fall on the ground? Yeah, before winter season, there is a season called spring. In that spring season, what happens, you know, children? The leaves turn yellow and red. And later, they fall on the ground like this. And this looks a beautiful scenery, children. The poet George Cooper, he wrote a poem. George Cooper, he is the poet. He wrote The Relation Between the Wind and the Leaves. Let me read the poem and tell you the relation, children. Come, little leaves, said the wind one day. Come, little leaves, said the wind one day. So, the wind is calling the leaves. Come, come to me, says the wind, to the leaves. How should they come? Come over the meadows with me and play. What happens when there is a big wind? Things which are very light in weight, they fly in the air. Usually, dry leaves, isn't it? Usually, leaves, they fly in the air like this. They fly in the air like this, isn't it? So, the wind is calling the leaves. Come to me, says the wind to the leaves. Put on, how should they come? Over the meadows. What are meadows, children? Grasslands. Meadows are lands full of grass. Imagine a land, a area without any houses and without any roads, full of green grass. And why the wind is calling the leaves? Come over the meadows with me and play. The wind is calling the leaves to play with her. The wind is calling the leaves to play with the wind. Put on your dresses of red and gold. Put on your dresses of red and gold. See, put on your dresses of red and gold. How are the colors of the leaves? Just now we saw. What are the colors of the leaves? Red and gold. See, gold, yellow is gold, red is this color. So, the wind is asking them to put on your colors. That means first they are green in color. See here, actually leaves are green in color. But after some time, during the spring season, they turn to yellow and afterwards red, and then they are falling on the ground. So, the poet is saying, come to the wind and play. So, the leaves are compared to red and gold dresses. Actually, he is not talking about dresses, but dresses means here red and gold colors of the leaves. For summer is gone and days grow cold. So, summer season is gone. Now, which season is entering? Yeah, now also we are enjoying winter season. Cold season is winter season. What is the cold season? Winter season. So, the wind is saying, let us enjoy the winter season. Let us play on the meadows. and enjoy. Soon as the leaves heard the wind's loud call, so who is calling the wind? Who is calling the leaves? Wind is calling the leaves. So when wind called the leaves, who heard it? The leaves heard it. And down they came, fluttering one and all. So when the wind called the leaves, they came, they moved slowly. Fluttering means flapping, flapping the wings like a bird. Flapping the wings like a bird. Flapping the wings like a bird. Okay. Over the brown fields, they danced and flew. Flew, past participle. Fly, fly, flew, flown. These are the past, present tense, past tense, and past participle. Flown, F-L-O-W-N, flown. So, over the, O-E-R here is over, O-V-E-R, over. Over the brown fields, they danced and flew. What are the brown fields? What are the brown fields here he is mentioning? The fields are full of crops. The fields are full of harvest season it is. It is the harvest season. Do you know what is a harvest season? Huh? Children, harvest season means when the crops are ready to be cut. When their crops are ready to be cut, that season is called harvest season. So, what the wind is asking, come over the brown fields, they danced and flew. So, when the wind called them, they came like a bird flapping their wings. Fluttering means flapping the wings or moving slowly. And they danced and flew and came to the ground. Singing the soft little songs they knew. See, what is the sound made by the leaves when they move? Do they do a huge sound? No, they don't do any huge sound. They make a very mystic sound, slow. The sound appearance will be very slow. So that sound is compared to song, little soft little songs. Okay, then dancing and whirling the leaves went. So the wind called the leaves and they are moving slowly. Now how are they going? Dancing and whirling. Whirling means move rapidly round and round. See, whenever there is a whirlwind. Do you know whirlwind? Sudigali. We call it Sudigali in Telugu. Yeah, whenever there is a whirlwind, how do leaves rotate, children? They move round and they move from one place to another. So that is called whirling. The little leaves went. So how the leaves are moving? They are moving round and they are moving on the ground. Winter had called them and they were content. So winter season entered. Up till now there was no winter season. They were waiting for the season and now the winter season entered. So how they are now? How the leaves are now? They are content. Content means satisfied. They are very satisfied in the winter season. Why? Before it was summer season and the atmosphere and the weather was very hot. So leaves also suffered a lot. Now it is winter season. So now they are satisfied. Soon fast asleep in their earthy beds. So now where are the leaves going? They are falling on the ground. Let me show you the picture. Say they fell down on the ground. Do you think they will be there only? What happened to the leaves afterwards? They will be buried on under the sand or under the mud. They will be buried. Buried means they will be kept under the sand or mud. And then what happens to those leaves? They become like a manure. Okay. And they are very satisfied when they go under the mud. Why they are satisfied? Because they came from the earth only, no? They came from the earth. So after they went again into the earth, so they felt very happy and they fast asleep. Fast asleep means immediately they fell asleep. The snow laid a coverlet over their heads. See? Now, not only the mud is covering it, earth is covering it. Now, who is covering them? Snow. What is snow? Snowfall. snowfall will be there in cool places, no? So this snowfall is, this snow is covering those leaves over their heads. Heads means you, heads, the wheels, the leaves doesn't have heads, but simply they are saying heads means fully they are covered. Right. Coverlet means cover. So let me once again remind you children, this is the poem about wind and the leaves. Wind and the leaves. The connection between the wind and the leaves. The understanding between the wind and the leaves. Who is calling the leaves? Wind is calling the leaves. Come little leaves, said the wind one day. Come over the meadows with me and play. Put on your dresses of red and gold, for summer is gone and the days grow cold. Soon as the leaves heard the wind's loud call, down they came fluttering one and all. Over the brown fields they danced and flew. Flew, I said, no, fly, flew, flown. These are the, this is the present tense, past participle. Singing the soft little songs they knew. Knew also past participle. No, new, known. Past tense. No, new, known. K-N-O-W-N, known. Dancing and whirling, the little leaves went. Winter had called them. They were content. Content, I said, satisfied. Meaning for content is satisfied. Soon after, soon fast asleep, asleep in their earthy beds. Here, earth is compared like a bed. The snow laid a coverlet over their heads. So, after they were covered under the earth, who is covering the earth? The snow. Snowfall is covering their heads. Okay, children, this is the poem about the wind and the leaves. And the author is George Cooper. In the next page, we have grammar. Let us discuss grammar in the next lesson, next video.